Hey guys, and welcome to a little extra video. As you may know, have noticed, well, this is not Forza Horizon. This is true. This is Forza Street. Now, if you have at any point spent any money on this game, you are getting royally, seriously, very much screwed. Because this game is a scam. Nothing more, nothing less. And I'm going to show you what's wrong. First of all, let's take this. This will guarantee you a 3-star car. Now, if we scroll down here, we will find here are the 3-star epic cars. Now, there's a 1% chance of getting a car in this category. But this is to be shared between all the cars. So if you're looking for, say, the Chevrolet Camaro ZL1, check this out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So that's 9 cars that share a 1%. Meaning, you have to take the 1% and divide it by 9. That's your actual chance of getting this car, for instance. But wait, you say. That's like 0.1%. That's like 1,000 cards to get. Yep. It is. Like I said, you are being royally screwed over. It gets better. The main way of tuning your car in this game is racing, where you get these challenge cards. Now, if you look at the legend for the challenge cards, you'll see unlocked at episode 1, 200 plus, etc., etc., etc. Now, the episode refers to this, the story mode, or so they call it. Which is episode 1, 2, 3, yada yada. And as soon as you unlock episode 3, you should be getting, here we go, you should be getting 300 CR, and these should be your bonuses. Meaning there's a 20% chance of a stage 5 tuning kit. Now, I did a bit of math. And I did a bit of, well, yeah, some would say this is stupid, but I took a note of every single challenge card I got for the last, well, quite a while, I believe. In total, it's 1,421 challenge cards. So, quite a while, actually. It's about 60 a day, roughly, give or take. And oh, you wouldn't believe. If you start calculating, and I mean calculate, because each kit, let me show you, not on that car, each kit gives you points. So this will give you 100 points, tuning points. Now you need X amount of points to go up one PI, right? Now if you start calculating on what I should have gotten, or what everybody should get as soon as they unlock episode 3, in my case, I am getting roughly half the tuning points I should get, according to the legend. Now, what did the company do about this? Oh, well, they hurried up and made it a known bug. First, it was, these numbers at episode 3 are not true. Then suddenly it was, all the numbers here are not true. They may or may not be working on a fix. There is no way to know when the fix will come out. Support wrote me that they have no timeline on when this is fixed. So at the moment, you're getting roughly 50% of the tuning points that you need, and about, give or take, half, a little bit more, 70, you're getting 75% of the credits that you should. So these, 250, 200, they should be 200 all of, or 300 all of them, because I unlocked episode 3. They are not, far from it. Most of them are up here. And yeah, it's one thing after another. Then there's rivals, where every week you get to race other people, apparently. Because you're not racing other people. May look like you're racing other people, but you're not. Because I've several times come across cars that are impossible. Cars with an extremely high PI and like 2 stars. And, well, first I was told, well, that's a known bug. Yeah. In the spotlight event, upgrade events, where we're racing AI, but here we're supposed to be racing other people's cars. We're not. This is also a scam. Let's see, what else do we have? Oh, yeah. Let me just show you here. Now, there are a bunch of cars here that you cannot have. This one, this one, this one, this one, this one, were all part of an event that played out in August 2019. These are not available anymore. But it does mean, as you can see, that there are people that every day in Rivals would have 4, 5, 6, up to 7 cars that you don't have, and you have no, absolutely no chance of getting. Apart from these, there are cars that are not even listed here. There are is the John Cooper Works, there's the Bel Air 57, there's the F40, or sorry, GT40, the old GT40. They're not even listed here. And again, this is cars you cannot have. You cannot get them. So there are people who will have like between 5 and 10 extra cars in Rivals every day. Yeah. And somehow, and this is rather interesting, if you take a car like this Porsche 918 Spyder. Now I have had hundreds of rolls in the Superclass, where this is one of the cars. There it is. And I have literally had hundreds of rolls. Never got it. Nope. Not even once. But in Rivals, most of the 918s you will come across are 5 stars. Now, what does it take to get a car to 5 stars? Well, assuming you roll a 3-star, that's how you get the car. Then you have to get that to 4 stars. That takes 5 3-star cards, something like that. Then you have to get it to 5 stars. That will take 17 cards. So, and going by this, you can see 1%, 4 cars, so that's 0.25% chance of getting the Porsche 918 Spyder. It would take an astronomical amount of rolls to get it to 5 stars. Yep. Lots of people have them. Also, all the McLarens you'll see, yep, all 5 stars, because reasons. There's no time frame on when they will give the rest of us access to the McLarens. Nope, not at all. And yeah, there are just some cars that are completely impossible to get, apparently. So, and I've been playing this for 3 months, something like that. And I do my daily races, and I have not gotten any of those yet. Apparently, I don't know. Maybe I'm just unlucky, or maybe the game is fucking rigged beyond belief. In short, you are getting royally fucked in the ass because they want you, they claim, oh, but it's, we want you to be able to play without paying. And yeah, they don't. They really don't. I mean, they want you to get stuff like this, for instance. These small, oh, go away. Small micropayments. They really, really want you to do that. And even if you do, the game is still rigged against you. Nice, go away. Like I said, with the upgrades. And apparently, support doesn't give a fuck. I mean, just this is really the one that bugs me the most. That our main point of income and tuning ability is so royally fucked up that you wouldn't believe it if I showed you the numbers. And all they can say is, well, they're wrong. We have no idea when it will be fixed. Please pay us some more money. Yeah. So this is me saying, fuck you very much, but no thank you. You could at least buy me dinner first. Thanks for watching. Bye.